We would like to be better versions of ourselves, right? So there gets to be a certain point where physically you can't do it anymore. So mentally you have to do it. The new client we have, Anthony, this guy's amazing, man. He's going to be 50 years old. He's got incredibly hard body, still trying to achieve, still trying to be the best. Great attitude. You know, he's a professional and he wants to bodybuild. You know, and these are the kind of people that I like to help. We got to interview him because he's got a great story, a very inspirational story for people out there to hear. Not just your typical, you know, bodybuilding, you know, blah, blah, blah. But I mean, real life stories that he overcome. He was in the coal mining industry, and he's a whistleblower for the corruption that's going on in there. And I don't know if you can imagine the coal mining industry that, you know, they tried for years to shut him down. The lawyers that they put on him and all the stuff that they did, and how, you know, he's coming out with a documentary, and how he's, you know, he's a fighter, you know, and that's the kind of people that I like, man. And this, everybody's got a little Tyrone in them. Everybody's got a little Muhammad Ali in them. Everybody, you know, has, and it's just, when are you going to bring it out? What are you going to bring it out to get that MBA? Are you going to bring it out to get your doctors in, you know, or are you going to bring it out to win your show? Are you going to bring it out to be a better father? Are you going to bring it out to save the relationship with your baby's mother so that she doesn't leave you? You know, I think this is, I think it's important these days, you know, we quit on each other as humans. We quit on each other so much, you know, that like there's, we end up growing up with a lack of like faith and attachment to who we are. So it's hard to really fight for what you believe in. You know what I mean? To be backed up against a corner. Nowadays, everybody's so lackadaisical about winning. And, you know, it's like you said, you know, after Rich Piana did those videos where he's coordinating everything, and it changed the way that people saw the gym. And it wasn't so much about, you know, a tough, hard effort into really, really training hard. It was kind of about like how much, if I take this and do that pre-workout and rub this stuff on my skin, then all this other stuff, I can look good and I'm going to take a picture of myself swole. I mean, that's just so far from what it was when we used to wear hoodies and train and, you know, we would go home and look at ourselves. We, you know.
So I wear big sweatshirts most of the time, and then I mean, baseball shirts under that. And under that I wear tank tops. And when I sweat through the top layer, I pull it off. And then the next layer until I can't wear it anymore, and then the next layer. So I don't care about how I look in the gym. I care about how I look when I'm not in the gym.
Do you notice that people just don't sweat these days, man? Like, I seriously just don't sweat.
I'm a freaking bathtub when I go to the gym.
Man, I sweat through the shirt, and then I have to take the shirt off and put another one on because it gets cold, you know? So it's that, like, almost every time, you know, that's if it go past a certain point, if I'm still sweating, I'll change the shirt. But if I stop sweating, that's actually how I gauge that the workout needs to end. Because when the sweating starts to, and I start to get, my temperature starts to go down regardless of the training, I know food, you got to eat. You know, when you're an ectomorph like that, you can't go that many hours without the food.
When I'm lean, I have to do that. When I'm fat, I can train forever.
If you and I were hanging out pre-technology, okay, I would have to manipulate you into saving my life because you would be able to survive days without food, right? I wouldn't be able to make it 5 minutes, you know?
You got to kill an elk and just drag it around.
Yeah. Well, you'd be the one carrying
it around, yeah.
I'd be there like talking to you about, man, the stars line up, but check that out over there as you're holding the elk. You know? I'm hungry. Let's eat. I'm good. You go ahead and eat, you know?